सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। Today's subject is activate your DNA and live long. Few Shastra Pramana, eternal truths about DNA activation and anti-aging. A research by Caroline from Galactic Foundation. They have a website, galacticfoundation.com. They say dormant DNA activation activates the dormant portions of the brain. Average person with one strand of activated DNA use only 10% of brain capacity. So DNA activation increases the capacity of the brain, and this is one truth, how the activation of DNA, the second strand, third strand, the next strands activates the capacity of brain. There is another one research, Dr. Rick Strassman states, so his research says DNA activation in turn activates the pineal gland, Ajna Chakra, located in the middle of the brain at the back of the third eye region. It is called seat of the soul. Inside the pineal gland is the master cell, which is the master key to all our functions, from color of our hair to the way we wiggle our feet. Beth Coleman, his research. This master cell in the pineal gland, as the youth and vitality chromosomes responsible for aging process, activation of this gland leads to increase in melatonin secretion responsible for anti-aging. Melatonin is anti-aging hormone. And there is another one research, Wellness Research Foundation. They say telomere is a portion of DNA that governs an aging process. Each time when a cell divides through the course of evolution, a small portion of this telomere is not copied to the other cells, making them shorter and shorter over time. This is the cause for aging. Aging is defined as per the science. I will define aging as per the consciousness. I will add my own experience on this line. There is another one beautiful research conclusion, Dr. by Philip D. Minton and Mr. Alciard. He says telomerase is an immortality enzyme that controls aging process by rebuilding the telomerase, but gene controlling this telomerase is switched off. Activation of telomerase enzyme leads to anti-aging. So these are some of the Shastra Pramanas, means the Pramanas from the ancient rishis or modern rishis. Now I will add Atma Pramana, my experience, to what it is. So it can be a Apta Pramana for you. The more and more life is added to your life, more strands of DNA is awakened. If the more strands of DNA is awakened, I always tell people life has to be measured by depth, not by length. Life need to be measured by depth, not by length. What Vivekananda did, just in 9 years of his public life, you can't comprehend. What Shankara did, just by 32 years of his life, you can't comprehend. Means, more strands of DNA is awakened in them. You may think, oh, I am talking about DNA and anti-aging, but they all live very short. Understand? It is not that they can't live, they did not want to live. There are two things. When you are deeper, more strands of DNAs are awakened, you will have a complete freedom to live or not to live. Understand? I am not all for living long. I am all for you having freedom to live long or not to live long. I am not saying you should live long or you should die quickly. No. But human beings should have a freedom to decide his death. It should be Iccha Mrityu. Means when you desire, you should leave the body. When the deeper strands of DNA, more strands of DNA is awakened, you will have, first thing, depth in life. Second, freedom about length in life. Understand? If you don't have depth, length can be torture sometimes. I have seen people who have a healthy body but not a healthy mind suffering in the old age in the depression. That's the worst punishment. Live long only by matured mind. Let the anti-aging happen by the maturity of the mind, maturity of the inner space. Not just physical strength. Let it happen by mental strength, then the life is worthy. Then the life is worthy. So come on, let me come to the subject of DNA and anti-aging. Every moment is given birth by the present moment. Next moment takes birth from the present moment. Next moment takes birth from that moment. If only one DNA strand is awakened in you, you are more matter, material. Constantly you will associate yourself with matter. Matter means what? Fear and greed base. So naturally, if this moment you feel yourself more as a body, the thought which is mixed with this moment, you see, the life is time and space. This moment is the time. The thought which is mixed with this moment is space. If this is based on fear and greed, next moment will be more tired than this moment. Then next moment will be little more tired than this moment. Please understand how the tiredness is added moment by your mind. If you feel you are a matter, naturally the fear and greed will be there in your inner space. So this moment, the time and fear and greed, these two is the mixture of your life at this moment. So when next moment is given birth from this moment, naturally that will also carry the fear and greed. One step more. One unit more. So naturally from that next moment takes birth. Again, one unit more fear and greed. So the more fear and greed gets added, every moment. That is what the scientists are saying, that let me give you the exact scientific research. The telomere, the portion of DNA that governs the aging process. Each time a cell divides through a course of evolution, a small portion of this telomere is not copied to other cells, making them shorter and shorter over time. Means from one cell to the other, 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 the whole thing is not copied. Naturally, when the matter interferes, the pure space gets reduced. Please understand, the more you feel as fear and greed, the pure space gets reduced. Only the fear and greed gets transmitted. So the quantity of matter becomes more and the quantity of consciousness is less in the transmission. So naturally, every moment you feel more and more tired. I tell you, actually, when you live consciously through mind, more you have experience, more it becomes wisdom. When you live unconsciously with the mind, more you live, more it becomes boredom. Whether your life is getting into the wisdom or boredom is dependent on the consciousness with which you are pushing your mind. Same way, whether you are aging or anti-aging is dependent on the way in which your consciousness is pushing your body. Please understand. If you are consciously living with your mind, every happening adds wisdom. It becomes experience, part of your intelligence. If you are unconsciously moving with fear and greed, every incident adds boredom. Oh God, one more desire, one more fear. Wisdom or boredom is dependent on the consciousness behind your mind. Same way, aging or anti-aging is dependent on the consciousness behind your body. If every moment your body handles fear and greed, you feel you are a matter, and next moment is given birth from this moment of fear and greed, naturally it leads to aging. Or if you feel with awareness, I tell you, if you can handle last 20 years of breathing, heartbeat, liver function, digestion, by now you should have become master of that. It should be more easy, more comfortable for you. So naturally, more number of years you live, you should be more experienced and more healthy. See the reality. See, for example, if you are driving for many number of years, you are supposed to be expert driver. Same way, if you are digesting for many number of years, you are supposed to be expert in digestion. If you are seeing many number of years through eyes, you are supposed to be expert in seeing. So with consciousness, you are supposed to be getting expertized. So you are supposed to be anti-aging by years, grow younger. It is because of unconscious beliefs you carry, delivered to you by society, an unconscious fear and greed you carry, which is responsible for telomere not being copied completely to the next cell. The small portion of this telomere is not copied to the other cells, making them shorter and shorter. Means the consciousness or the life portion is not transmitted completely. Why? Because that every moment takes birth from fear and greed. When the fear and greed is the womb, naturally it becomes more and more matter, less and less consciousness. Understand two things. If you are living with clear awareness, witnessing consciousness, every incident happens in front of you becomes wisdom for your mind. Hey, now I know how to handle this situation. Wow, now I am expert in consciously, if you deal the situations, you become expert, whether your body or mind. If it consciously handles, witnessing consciously handles all the situation, two things will happen. Your mind will have wisdom, your body will have the anti-aging process. If you handle it unconsciously with fear and greed, deeply settled in matter, rooted, caught in matter, your mind gets boredom. So awakening, the next strands of DNA directly leads you to awareness. The intense awareness directly leads you to the awakening of deeper strands of DNA. But it's a vicious circle. Understand? It's a vicious circle. When you try to awaken the DNA, you feel you don't have enough awareness. If you try to have enough awareness, you feel enough strands of DNA is not awakened. How to break the vicious circle? That is where the role of the master's play comes in. That is where the master's role comes in. Transmission of lamp is needed. Person whose all strands of DNA is awakened can easily physically transmit and awaken your next level strands of DNAs, second, third, fourth, fifth. If only one strand of your DNA is awakened, you can easily awaken at least next five. If already three is awakened in you, you can easily activate next 10. Sorry, totally 12. Next 9. You can activate the whole thing. So pushing you to the next level happens by initiation. That is what exactly I am doing in inner awakening. Taking you step by step. First, removing all the fear engrams. Then, greed engrams. Then deeper engrams related to matter, removing the mud in which you are stuck, and through initiation awakening all strands of DNA, so that you can have wisdom and anti-aging, grow younger. Please understand, growing older is the worst crime done to the humanity by the ancient civilizations. Do not live in a village where people live very short span of life. Bernard Shaw, suddenly at the age of 90, he left his place where he was living all his life, all his friends, family, relatives, the nostalgical, memorious places, everything he left and went away to a place where people live for a long time. They asked, why? What happened to you? He says, no, I should be in a place constantly where I am reminded human age is not 100. He's right. So go and be in a place somewhere, constantly these truths are taught. You don't need to grow in boredom. You don't need to be aging. Where people are growing younger and growing in wisdom. Growing in wisdom, growing younger. If you have that kind of a community, at least spend 21 days a year. Ramakrishna says, if you drink too much of arak, drink at least half a liter of rice water. That effect in the alcohol, effect of the alcohol in the body, the arak in the body will go away. So if you live in the society where people grow old and get into boredom, at least 21 days live in a place where people grow younger and grow in wisdom. That is why exactly I designed the Inner Awakening program for 21 days. To give them the experience of growing younger and growing in wisdom. The Inner Awakening is specially designed to awaken the deeper strands, next level strands of your DNA. First, removing fear and greed. Second, making you free from time. Third, making your inner space pure, so that every moment takes birth out of pure and pure inner space. The telomere is completely reproduced, not only completely reproduced little more than what it was. Adding. So every cell gives birth to a better cell. Nowadays the machineries have come, they themselves can produce the next generation machinery. More precious, more perfect. With more precision and more perfection. Without human touch, they can just automatic machineries. They can make more precision machineries, more perfect than them. So what will happen? Next generation. The more generation the machineries are moved, naturally more precision and perfect machineries are going to come out. Same way, once the pure consciousness is activated in you, at least 5 strands of DNA is activated in you, naturally, the more conscious moment will be given birth from this conscious moment. So the aging process is reversed. That's what I mean, grow younger. And grow in wisdom, not in boredom. You can't speak much about it because it's a process. See, as a technique I can give practice awareness, but I myself know you can't practice, because unless the DNA is awakened, you can't become aware. Unless you become aware, DNA can't be awakened. You are caught. So the only solution is transmission of lamp, initiation. That happens only in the master's presence. And when master works on it, on you, step by step, I think we can do some of the scientific researches and prove solidly how when the fear and greed is removed from a person, how when the pure consciousness is added to the person, simply the next strands of DNA gets activated. We'll be able to prove. So I think that is the only solution. Once we prove, naturally people will be interested in the process with the master. So process with the master, Upanishad, process with the master is the only way for growing younger and growing in wisdom. The inner awakening will awaken the DNA. I think I can name it as DNA awakening. Inner DNA awakening. Inner awakening leads to DNA awakening. And that naturally leads to more awareness, growing younger and growing in wisdom. I bless you all to experience inner awakening by the Upanishad, sitting with the master, and the community which is growing younger and growing in wisdom. and achieve and radiate enlightenment. Let you all achieve and radiate enlightenment. Let you all achieve and radiate the eternal bliss. Nityananda, thank you.
All that I taste, all that I smell.